सर डॉक्टर भारती, प्रिंसिपल फिजियोथेरेपी डिपार्टमेंट, RPIIMS कैंपस करनाल। सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फंक्शन ऑफ SCM। व्हाट द SCM स्टैंड्स फॉर? SCM इज बेसिकली द स्टर्नोक्लीडोमेस्टॉइड। एज द नेम स्टर्नोक्लीडोमेस्टॉइड, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सम थ्री बोन्स लाइक स्टर्नम। क्लीडो मीन्स क्लेविकल एंड मेस्टॉइड मीन्स अ मेस्टॉइड प्रोसेस। So before functioning of the SCM or the manual testing of the SCM, we must know the origin and the insertion of some particular muscles. So when we talk about sternocleidomastoid, so we must know about the origination of the sternocleidomastoid. As the name suggests, sternum. This is our sternum and this is the xiphoid process, this is the manubrium. So first part, it consists of two heads. One head is originated from the manubrium. That is the sternal part. Manubrium is a part of the sternum. And the cleido part is the clavicle bone. That is another head is originated from the clavicle bone. That is the medial aspect of the clavicle. So, sternocleidomastoid muscle is originated from the sternum as well as the clavicle. And the another part is mastoid. So, it is inserted at the mastoid process. Mastoid process is just below the behind the ear. When we palpate with the index finger, we must have some node-like or nodule-like structure, and when we press it deeply, it becomes painful. When it becomes painful, that suggests that indicate that this is the mastoid process. And sternocleidomastoid muscle is inserted at the mastoid process. So, sternocleidomastoid muscle is originated from the manubrium, that is the part of the sternum, and the medial aspect of the clavicle, that is our the collarbone, cleido, and inserted at the mastoid process. So, if the direction of the fiber is like that, it is originated from the manubrium of the sternum and the inserted at the mastoid process. So, now we come to the function. After when we know about the origin and the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid, now we come to the function of the sternocleidomastoid. So, what are the function? For any muscle, whenever it is contracted, so that means there is a shortening of the muscles. So, first function of the sternocleidomastoid is contralateral rotation. First function is, this is the, if we assess the one side, it is a bilateral muscle. So sternocleidomastoid muscle has a unilateral function as well as bilateral function. So when we first we talk about the unilateral effect or unilateral function of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. So sternocleidomastoid, the unilateral function is opposite side rotation, that means contralateral rotation of the neck, as it is the muscle of the neck. So first function is the contralateral rotation of the neck. As we why we use the term contralateral means it is when we contract the muscle fiber becomes shortened. So muscle is like that only, two head of the muscle. So when it is contract, it becomes stretched or the contracted. So that's why one function is a contralateral rotation. So when we assess the muscle of the right side, so function of the SCM or the sternocleidomastoid is one function is contralateral rotation. If we assess the unilateral side, now another effect is ipsilateral side flexion, and the contralateral rotation is one of the major function of the sternocleidomastoid muscle when we assess the or when we check the muscle unilaterally. Now these are the cervical vertebrae, and there are so many muscle attachments or the ligamentous attachment at the level of the cervical vertebra. So another function when we check the sternocleidomastoid muscle bilaterally is the, it is also helps in the cervical flexion. So before analyzing or before knowing the origin and the insertion of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, we must aware about the function of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. I repeat again, first is the contralateral rotation, that is the unilateral function, ipsilateral side flexion, that is the unilateral function, and the neck flexion. So that is all about the function of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Thank you so much.